Hey friends, I hope you're enjoying this first day of spring break, this beautiful Saturday, April day. I just wanted to reach out to you guys and say how much I appreciate all of your encouragement and support over the last several weeks. It's been a very challenging time. As you know, there's no playbook for this kind of thing, and we're certainly in uncharted territory. Over the last couple weeks, the leadership team and I have been working really hard to try to provide some continuity of instruction, as well as continue to feed our students that are in need, and really appreciate all the efforts from our school nutrition department and our transportation department and the leadership team and the volunteers that have come out on Mondays and Wednesdays to help out. Just want to say thank you to all those folks and to thank all of you for your patience and understanding as we try to figure out what to do next. We're starting a web page now of frequently asked questions. It's on our web page, and I want to encourage you, if there's a good question that's out there that hasn't been answered or hasn't been asked, you know, to please reach out to me or any of your principals and ask a good question so we can keep current and relevant information out to our community. Oftentimes you guys are the ones, you know, that hear about the kind of those friction points before we do, so we'd ask for your help in that. You know, certainly when we started this journey, we were thinking we were going to be out of school for a couple weeks at most, and now it looks like it's going to turn into several months. And you know, we've done our very best to try to provide some relevant continuity of instruction. And certainly at this point in time, you know, there's going to be people that look back and say we should have done more. Some people are going to say we should have done less. And that's okay, because, you know, hindsight gives clarity, but in the moment, we were certainly doing the kind of things that we thought were best to keep everyone safe and to provide opportunities for students to be successful going forward. And, you know, I think what this has really shown is that there really is a digital divide among some of our rural districts and some of our more metro districts. And I believe that message is being heard by folks at the Golden Dome, and those people in the governor's mansion are really hearing that message loud and clear, that there really is a digital divide in Georgia, and it really does have some ramifications across the board in equity for our students. And as we've tried to move forward over the last couple weeks, we've been really thinking through all of our decisions with an equity lens and making sure that we were treating all of our students fairly and giving everyone the same advantage, the same opportunity to move forward with some learning activities, albeit we understand there were some limitations there, you know. But first and foremost, in times like these, you know, we're worried about folks' safety, and it's hard for a school superintendent to sit here and tell you, but, you know, education at this point really is not the priority. The priority is to keep people safe and keep people healthy. We don't want to do anything that continues to add to the stress of our families. Many are in really difficult situations, as we're seeing record unemployment and layoffs happen, and so we want to be sensitive to those things as well. But all that being said, I just want to tell you that I love you, and I appreciate all your support, and we'll continue to do the very best we can going forward. So if you have a good idea, as always, we want to hear it. So happy spring break, and I look forward to seeing all of you really soon.